thumbs up, but yes. So welcome back. It was a very productive break. What we'd like to do is encourage all of you in the audience, although you may have asked many of them offline, to ask some questions of the panel. But I'll start with the first question, and it is it's more of an economic outlook kind of question. But I'll throw out a hypothetical, and that is, and we've talked about the fiscal cliff, but let's assume that regardless of how the election goes, that Congress and everybody extends the tax cuts and sequestration gets resolved, and all of a sudden there's stability in the outlook. Do you expect 2013 to be, for economic activity generally to speak up, pick up, and for that to have a positive impact on the small, medium-sized business market, startups, IPOs, and all of the above? And we'll start with Tom.
I think that the things that you speak to will have a positive impact on getting those resolved, or just even getting to the next year on people moving forward with some business investment and some decisions that they've been prolonging. I think the situation in Europe will continue to get worse. I think that China seems to be slowing down. And so I think that there still is, even with the interest rates, the discount rate's now been almost 4 years at 0.25%, which should be incredibly stimulating. But I think that it's still going to be an iffy year because people are looking at best at 2% GMP growth. And so there's just not a lot of demand. So I think it will be sector by sector.
And I would agree. I think the sort of consensus forecast for next year is in the 2% range, assuming a lot of things get fixed. Obviously, there's the doomsday forecast of a significant downturn if a lot of the fiscal cliff actually fall off the virtual fiscal cliff. I think it's, we are in a tough period going forward. And you mentioned China. I think China is clearly slowing down. It will have a significant impact on the U.S. Brent, you want to give us your outlook?
I will, except I can't do it under the premise of your hypothetical because I'm contrary.
Okay.
I actually think that the election next week makes all the difference in the world. I think we're looking at a tale of two very different outcomes. There was a famous conference that was held in, I think, 1948 or 1949, where they brought together the leaders of the big companies in the United States. And they asked these folks, there's a big room like this probably, chairs weren't as nice because it was a different time. And they said, so you're essentially the same folks who were running your companies through the 1930s, early 40s, you're booming today, you weren't booming then, what's different? The consensus response around the room was Roosevelt didn't like us. And we weren't willing to commit resources in terms of capital investment, hiring decisions, developing new products and technology while he was in the office because we didn't know what he would do to us next. That's the environment we live in today. So I think that if this election gives us the status quo, I think the outlook for 2013 is bleak. I think what we will see is an extremely large exodus of capital from these shores. I think large companies are sitting on a lot of money right now. Why aren't they spending it? Well, they've had it presumably on their balance sheets for 3 years. They're waiting for something. I suspect they're waiting for next Tuesday. And once they get the verdict on that, I think they might find a way to deploy that capital overseas. On the other hand, I'm extremely rosy about if we vote for hope and change. And have a new administration, because I think that that money will come back into the marketplace, and it will come back into the marketplace in a positive way, it will come back here. Final thing is, with regard to the deficit and the problems, they're huge. They're so huge, and we are such a nation now of sort of spoiled children, that we're not going to solve this problem by making spending cuts. It won't happen. We won't stand for it. We also can't have our taxes raised. The only way out of this is to grow out of it and at least get it to a tolerable level. Because other than that, I don't think we have the appetite for it. So I'm pro-growth, and you can probably guess how I'm stacking up on the election. That's my forecast.
And I actually couldn't agree more. If you look historically, when I was at Chase, If you look historically, the media is quite, I'm trying not to make too many political comments, but the media is terrible at understanding the difference between rates and revenue. Historical evidence is overwhelming that every time there's been a significant rate reduction, revenue actually goes up. I mean, in the early 60s, in the early 80s, and actually in the early 2000s, revenues doubled in the 80s with lower tax rates. And there's the only way to address, I mean, I do think there needs to be some fiscal restraint for sure. But
it needs to be. I'm just not confident.
I know. I could go on forever about that, but I won't. But I do think that you're absolutely right in that if people understood the effect that marginal tax rates have on revenue because of growth, it's irrefutable evidence. I mean, it's always true. If you want to kill revenue, I mean, Delaware threw in the millionaire's tax, and their tax revenues actually went down because all the millionaires left Delaware, which is not a surprise. I mean, you tax it, you get less of it. And so it's not a surprise, but it really is grossly misunderstood, or if people understand it and grossly misrepresent it, then it's even worse. But we do need substantial growth. And before Tom came, and I was talking about what 2% growth rate means, what 1.5, and you really need at least 3.5 to 4% growth rate to have a significant change, and we're so far below that. But Gary,
it's interesting. I would agree with many of the comments that both Brent and Tom made. Maybe with one slight disagreement where Brent's coming from. First of all, I like the concept that we could actually look forward to 2013 in a cooperative environment. I think that's very optimistic. But let's hope that that is the case, because it really doesn't matter so much.
It's my very hypothetical.
That's fine. But I think the bigger item is, at what point do we start creating certainty? Because in addition to the rates, I think you're going to find the business community is looking for certainty, even if it's a high rate. We don't like that. But you can plan for that if you know what that certainty is. So that would be one element I would add to that. I believe firmly, we're talking 2014 before we see anything happening. 2013, at best, is a formative year. And I think that's at best. I think there's so much that needs to change, even if we keep the current administration in. There's going to be massive change still coming down the road. Just trying to digest what's happening with the medical system, digest what's going to happen with the fiscal cliff as we see it. All of that has to come in and play its way out. I mean, there's so much. That's 2013. And you're suggesting something more rosy than that. Where I would tend to disagree a little bit. We talk about the exit of mass amounts of capital. Where's it going to go? What better country do you have than the United States? And I'm not waving a flag, but just take a look around the world. We still have the very best economy that exists anywhere in the world, the best law system, the best way of innovating, the best way of attracting capital, of being able to spend capital. Yes, we go and we do rely on other countries to help fund some of our debt. No question about that. But the businessman, where are they going to send their money? You'll see it sitting in banks and some investments. You'll see it underdeployed. And that's the crime.
Right.
But at the end of the day, we have to get our systems down so that we can reinvest in what the country can do. And historically, I'm glad you bring up the history here, historically, we've always done extremely well when we've had the chance to allow the spirit of democracy and free enterprise to actually thrive. And that's what we're missing right now.